Folks, my proposal is simple. Return to the original recipes and restore the M-Time brand to its former glory. Yes, sugar instead of corn syrup, and the elimination of polysorbate and other crap will add to the per unit cost and cut into the margins. We make up the difference by streamlining inefficiencies and trimming bloated executive compensation and perquisites, beginning with the corporate jet.
I started at the bottom.
The scrumpets taste fine.
You came on as a 22-year-old vice president, and you raped the scrumpet.
I eat them. I eat scrumpets and ding-doodles and cuckoo nutties, and they are good.
They're not as good.
But they're still very, very good. Delicious.
Listen to me. I move that effective immediately, Hutchinson Bailey III be removed from his duties as chief executive officer of the Yum Time Corporation.
Hang on a minute here. Perk, you're being con!
Is there a second?
Second.
Motion carries.
I'll get my company back. Somehow.
I now move to remove Evelyn Benson from this body and delegate her seat to Robert Axelrod.
What?
Second.
I'll go to the press.
If you do, you'll be burned down with your own match. All those in favor? Motion carries. Good luck, Evelyn.
She treated me like I was just the wife. Like my business wasn't ready.
I tried to tell you. Yeah, you weren't ready, but you wouldn't hear it from me.
You put me in touch with Spartan Ives. You said to go ahead.
No, don't. I don't have time to have this conversation the way you need me to. You weren't ready? Leave it there.
Why the fuck not?
What is it that you do that you're the best in the world at? You offer a service you didn't invent, a formula you didn't invent, a delivery method you didn't invent. Nothing about what you do is patentable or a unique user experience. You haven't identified an isolated market segment, haven't truly branded your concept. You need me to go on? So why would an investment bank put serious money into it? I all but told you ahead of time, but you wouldn't listen. Now you've heard it, but it's too late. You weren't ready. Now, I gotta go into New York to try and save my fucking quarter.
Asked him to go against the DNA, which is telling each of you to be greedy. Yes, be hungry, subjugate and conquer. Because that's who we are. That's what we are. Capitalism harnesses that better than any other economic model on Earth. Everything we have is because of capitalism. Because someone had an incentive to get up off his ass, to out-invent, to out-earn, yes, and to subjugate others. Less capable, less intelligent, less ambitious, less lucky to make those capitalistic dreams come true. You know what I'm talking about, Headmaster Kessel. The dirty secret you may not want to hear, but you fucking love the result. As will you, soon enough. The entire hedge fund industry is under siege. In the great expanse of time, we are already dead. I know it, even if you don't. But in this microsecond that we are still breathing air, I'm gonna fight the inevitable. If you have a card in front of you, pick it up, hold it in front of your face. If this room represents all the hedge funds in business, the uncovered faces are the only ones left in 18 months' time.
I made it.
Is that right, Mafie? You made it? Because this was a random fucking exercise, and I don't see any evidence at all that you're gonna.
In my private life, in the confines of my happy marriage with my consenting wife, practice sadomasochism.
Yeah.
Bondage, dominance, all the rest. Masks, binds, ropes, fire. Wow. Even just saying it like that, I can feel my shoulders loosen for the first time in decades. I am a masochist. In order to achieve sexual gratification, I need to be tied up, punched, pinched, whipped, kicked, or otherwise tortured. By my loving wife.
So do I call you Mistress Cassie, or Goddess, or... this?
It's not about me.
Oh, maybe you found other outlets.
How dare you question me? I can take care of my own needs.
Oh. And explored other fantasies, then.
What fantasies exactly?
You being with other men.
Of course.
Can you tell Chuck why it bothered you so much that he wore that suit?
Yeah, he can't for a second let anyone forget he is the United States Attorney for the Southern District, so the suit. It's not enough for him to think his profession is a calling while everyone else merely has a job. He needs to prove it at all times.
Do you think I can't tell the way people look at us? Don't you think that I know that you can do better than me? Maybe I want to wear something that won't make them look at us and wonder, gee, what is she doing with him? I went on a date, I think. No, it was a date. A woman from jiu-jitsu. Nothing really happened.
I feel like I should volunteer something too in the spirit of honesty. Yeah, I have something to admit. You don't look ridiculous. You look fucking hot.
But it seems like just yesterday you were striding in my office to tell me that you had nothing to lose. Or was it the day before yesterday? And yesterday was when you were telling me that it was worth it for you to go down with me. This is personal. It's not judicial. And this is when I finally get my chance to prove it.
Oh, yes. He will get the day in court he so richly deserves. Once I have everything in order, and I will, quite soon, it'll happen. Mr. Axelrod will surrender to me.
That's a legal term, to be clear, Chuck. So I will, technically. But note this. I will be fighting you till I die.